nobody looking at you. You bitches can't tell what makes. You bitches can't tell what makes.
Hey you guys, what's up? It's your girl Barbie Roma and you are back with me. Another Valentine's Day tutorial. This is an anti-Valentine's Day tutorial. This is for all the girls who are single and or you don't believe in Valentine's Day. This is just something fun. I started off with the Zulu palette. I'm dipping into that orange shade, and I'm gonna place the orange shade, the orange's reddish shade that's in there, on my lid as well, and more so in my crease. So the brush that I'm using is kind of like a stiff sponge kind of brush, but I use this because it helps me draw out shapes better, and I'm trying to get that circular shape on point. So usually I use this because this really helps. Then as you guys can see, after that I go in with two separate blending brushes. This is just to bring the two orange shades together, then blend the lines, they don't look too harsh, and so that you get more of that orangey red color than you get that initial like bright orange color. The bright orange color is just to basically be a base kind of for that brighter, not the brighter orange, but the reddish orange. And here I begin to cut my crease. You guys of course can't see because I gotta look up to do this, but I'm using this ivory color eyeshadow. I told you guys I got a few weeks back at Walmart. It's the Ruby Kisses mineral concealer. It was on sale for $2, and I feel like this one is better than using any of my other concealers, because this has a more lighter shade. It's easier to pat down and more easier to work with, and also it has a wand, like a I forget what you call those kind of wands, but like the ones that come in the lip gloss, it has one of those, and then it's easier to pat down with a more, you know, like angled eyeshadow brush. And that's what I'm doing, but you guys of course can't see it because I'm looking up too far and my camera is already zoomed in. So next I'm taking this blue shimmery eyeshadow pencil. I actually got this because my job, we won like some kind of contest and we got nominated or something. So people from Mary Kay came and gave us some makeup stuff. So I'm just putting it down as a base for the color that I'm going to put on my lid. The color I'm going to use on this look is basically the same thing. And I'm just going to spray my eyeshadow brush after this and place that shimmer shade all over my lid. And as per usual, I'm basically just cleaning up my eyeshadow with any size pink clips. And what I'm going to do this tutorial, which I usually never do, is I'm going to show you guys the foundation and stuff that I'm wearing and like my face routine, which I'm going to go through really quick. So I picked up the Maybelline SuperStay foundation, and you guys, this foundation is life. It is life. Like, I don't know what Maybelline did to make this foundation completely different than the Fit Me foundation, but when I tell you this foundation is bomb, it is bomb. Like, It doesn't have any like chemical strong smell. It literally smells like water to me. So crazy. So I'm super excited. I wore it today to school and oh my god, it literally lasted all day. And it didn't budge, it didn't move. Like, it's crazy. It's really crazy. So whenever y'all see me singing and getting lit and my tutorials, it's because of the stages I listen to on Pandora. Like, they be so lit. And I think I was listening to B5 Radio again. And it was playing SZA, so you know I was going off. And all the talk I'm doing, I'm talking to my mom and my brother, so don't mind me. But I'm going in with the e.l.f. HD Lifting Concealer to highlight underneath my eyes and on my face. And as usual, I'm going to bake with the Coty Airspun Powder and Honey Beige. And yeah, and I'm going to go on with my ABH Contour Palette in Medium to Tan. And I think that's all the steps I do right here. Let me just watch as I do this voiceover, and if I gotta come back in and say something, I shall. I forgot to mention that in this video, I did not color correct. I totally forgot to put my color corrector in my little makeup bag I bought to where like I do my little studio space. I don't know how I did that, but I mean, with this foundation, I didn't even need to do it because it was just so bomb and so full coverage that, I mean, it didn't even matter at this point. Like, so I just kept it pushing and kept it moving. Oh, so you guys, I'm trying out the new Wet n Wild matte setting spray. You guys know my holy grail is the natural finish, but this matte, somebody told me like I might fall in love with it, and it is really good. So I don't know, I'm gonna like alter between using both, I think, now, because I still have a lot of the white left. So when I buy them, well, I can just buy two. So I'll have the matte finish and the natural finish, because I really, really, really love them both. I say my setting spray, Jesus, I can't even speak, and contour my nose real quick. And then I'm just finish up my face. So in my brow bone, I pop on this new highlight from the Ultimate Glow Kit. So these last couple clips, you're gonna see me like staring off into space because I felt like there was something missing. So that's why I started to add a bunch of like stuff. So I decided to go underneath my eye with another color from the Juvia's Place palette. And then I go back and I'm turning up. I don't even know what song that was, honestly. I'm going in underneath my eye with the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil and Milk. I asked my mom basically to pick what color I should put under my eye. So we You guys, I start cracking up, right? Because my mom tells me that every day when she goes to work, my hair is in her purse. Hair sheds. At least we know it's real. Right, it's shedding. So the liquid eyeliner I'm using, I picked up from the hair store a couple of years ago. I don't even know if they sell this stuff still. I'm definitely going to check and find out because I love this stuff. It's an electric blue metallic liner and I freaking love this stuff. This stuff, it stands out on its own. I get, of course, because you know, eyeliner isn't my friend. So I get one eye right and then I get the last one a little mess up, so I have to go off camera and fix it, of course. But I'm doing my mascara here. I'm doing the same thing I've been doing, using the fiber mascara. Then I use the Voluminous Lashes and the Telescopic from L'Oreal. And I just had to make sure my lashes was popping, okay? Because, honey, if you're going out on Valentine's Day, like I said, you need to be shapopping, like, absolutely shapopping. And once again, you guys, I have to make this clear all the time. I'm not a makeup artist. I'm more of a makeup enthusiast. So when I'm filming these tutorials, you guys are learning with me. And I'm creating these looks all throughout creativity and ideas that I'm coming up with on my own. And it's like you basically come along with my journey as I grow with me. And I appreciate anybody who gives me credit when due and says they see me growing, because I truly appreciate that. And yeah, a lot of people think I'm a makeup artist. I'm really not. I'm really not a makeup artist, seriously. I give so much credit to those who are makeup artists, because perfecting your craft is really, 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 really hard. But I just love that blue liner. Like, I'm taking that to the grave with me. So yeah, I don't even know. I'm going in to highlight my face with the three golden shades and the Ultimate Glow palette. And like I said, then I'm going to put the ABH liquid lipstick on in Sad Girl. I've been getting all my ABH products from Marshalls lately. If y'all don't know that Marshalls got all the goodies, y'all better go rack up right now. They have the ABH lip palette and the Aurora highlight palette on sale in multiple Marshalls and TJ Maxx's, so make sure.
Can't tell what makes. You bitches can't tell what makes.